Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to give a review on Zomato IPO. So the first thing I would like to talk is the risk relating to the business or industry. I think there were at least 15 points that they have given about the risk regarding to their company. From that only I have taken 17 points. So the first thing that they are saying that we may not be able to sustain our historical growth rates and our historical performance may not be indicative of our future growth of financial results. We may also experience a decline in our revenue growth rate as of numbers of factors include slowing demand for our platform, insufficient growth or number of restaurant partners that utilize our platform, increasing competition, decrease in growth of our overall market, or our failure to capitalize may be due to increasing regulatory costs. The second thing is that we have a history of net loss and we anticipate increase in expense in the future. So from the last 3 years, that is 1069 billion, 10,102 billion, 23,856 billion and 6,821 billion for the respective year 2018, 2019 and 2020. So if we are unable to generate revenue growth, our expenses and cash flow may continue to incur suffers losses in the future. So the COVID-19 pandemic or similar public health treatment may impact our future, further impact our business cash flow or financial condition. And also the fourth point is if we fail to retain our existing partners, customer delivery partners that add to our portfolio, will increase in cost effective manner, our business may adversely affected. So, and the fifth point is growth of our business will depend on the strength of our brand. So failure to maintain the brand will limit their ability to expand the customer base. So the sixth one is unfavorable media coverage could harm our business and financial condition and also cash flow. So the seventh one is we face intensive competition in food delivery business, and if we are unable to compete, then surely our operation could be adversely affected. Eighth point that they are saying is that we do not continue to innovate or further develop our platform, then we are not able to keep pace with technology development or not remain in competition, and our business and our results could suffer. And the ninth one is failure to generate or maintain sufficient high quality customer generation could also negatively impact our business. System failure, interruption could adversely affect our business. And also security breaches, cyber attacks and potentially resulting breaches that could damage our reputation and negatively impact the business. So, and the 12th point is if we are unable to acquire, acquisition and invest in complementary business, I think they are talking about Uber Eats in this case. And if we are unable to do that or successfully integrate into our business, then it will lead to a failure. And the 13th one is our sales and marketing efforts to attract customers and restaurants may turn out to be ineffective. And the 14th one is the wide variety of payment methods we accept subjects us to the third party also, which may possess some risk. We rely on skills, experience of our senior managers also and personals, and the loss of our team members could be materially affect our business. 16th one, we rely on third party service providers. Any disruption in interference will adversely affect our business, financial condition, cash flow and the result of our operation. And the 17th one is we rely on restaurant partners, okay, and participation of the platform to provide quality service. Their illegal authorization and misconduct may lead to a failure. Now, I am going to tell you about financials in brief, because so the loss for the period is on March 31st, 2018. In 2018, the loss was 4,870. Okay. And the thing that we are doing here, I am trying to explain to you, is as this is the revenue that was being generated, that is 4,870, and from that 2018 to 2019 it has increased by 65%, and then in 2020 it has increased by 49%, and in December 31st 2020 it reduced again to 100 to negative 100%, because here we are only taking 1 year basis, in which there are 3 quarters, so I think the full data is not even on the prospectus. And now if we talk about the loss in the year 2018, the loss was 1069 billion, and from 2018 to 2019 the loss has increased by 89%. Oh my, the loss has increased by 89%. From 1000 million then it became to 10102 billion loss. The loss has increased from 2018 to 2019, and from 2019 to 2020 it has increased again by 57%. Please keep in mind these things. It is from 10,102 billion, it increased by 57% to 23,856,000. I'm talking about millions here. And now from 31st March 2020 to December 31st 2020, on 3 quarters, the loss has been reduced. Finally, in that quarter it has been improving. It has reduced by 2049%. And the cash that was there is from 2018 was 1003, and it has been drastically increasing 2124, then from 2124 in 2019 it reduced again to 1672, and from there onwards it became 2482. So let me talk about why they are borrowing the money from the public. It's not borrowing, it is offer for sale. Yeah, but because they require funds, and in that they have stated that for inorganic growth initiative 56,250 million that will be allocated for funding organic and inorganic growth. And under organic growth initiative they have customer and user acquisition, delivery infrastructure, technology infrastructure. And in inorganic they have acquisition. First one is Uber Eats India. To enlarge, why they are doing this acquisition? To enlarge existing customer base and increase market share. And second one is in Cathero Technologies, to directly provide logistic services for online orders based on Zomato. So this is the reason that they are doing it. And the industry overview is our market opportunities. So they expect India's GDP to be 4.4 trillion by 2025. Oh my god, I really don't know who is the secretary of who has written this report, but the secretary is expecting that in by 2025 our economy will be 4.4 trillion. It can happen, maybe. The strength of our Indian economy is underscored by the following factors: rising consumption, large working population, growth in urbanization. So the total addressable food service market opportunity is 110 billion by 2025. And they have also competition like food services and competitive markets in India comprise of delivery players like Zomato, Swiggy, Cloud Kitchen, like Rebel Foods. Branded food service players include Domino's, McDonald's, Pizza Hut among them. So our platform means Zomato is doing B2C offer, that is food delivery, dining out, and also business to business, that is hyper pure. And also they have this membership of Zomato Pro, which encompasses both food delivery along with dining. And under food delivery, they have laid down this process, cost of food reduction. Of the first one is they retain commission by Zomato and along with amount transferred to the restaurant. So the second time will be delivery charges paid by the user, it will be passed to the delivery partners, and packaging charges and tips. And fourth one, if tips will be passed to the delivery partners, and also additional fees and advertising revenue under dining out. Now they also have this called dining out. Dining out, our customers use our dine out offer to search and discover restaurants, read and write customer generator reviews, views and upload photos, book a table and make payments. Okay, so there is something called hyper pure also. In hyper pure, it is our theme farm to fork. Farm to fork supply means the fresh source of fresh hygienic quality ingredients are supplied from farmers, mills and producers to restaurant partners. And under Zomato Pro, we have paid membership program, which unlocks flat percentages and discounts at selected restaurant partners. So these discounts are available on all days except during free predetermined festivals. So as per 31st December, 1.4 million Pro members, and they have 25,000 Pro million members. So as when their advertising is concerned, it is like more content, more value for customers and more customers. So whenever they are doing advertisement, they keep this thing in mind: more content, more value for customers and more customers. And for home delivery transactions to more restaurants on the platform for delivery and more customers. So this is the cycle, like more customers, more delivery transaction, more restaurants on the platform for delivery, and also more content means more value for customers. So lower cost of fulfillment per unit, lower prices and more delivery. So in order to achieve more delivery, low cost of fulfillment per unit and low prices. Now whenever more delivery transaction is to be made for more customers, they will have more restaurants on the platform for delivery. So more restaurants on the platform for delivery will enable them to conduct more delivery transactions and more customers. Also more content will acknowledge more value for customers. And they have given this graph, I will share you. Let's see, I will share to you this graph. Advertising and sales promotion expense. So in the year 2018 it was 16%, and in 2019 they have suddenly increased the expense to 88%, and it dropped again into 48% in 2020, and now it is 22% on 2021. So this is the thing that I would like to say is, personally I am not interested in the IPO. There are so many already listed companies or recently listed companies on BSE which I would be more interested. So thank you for watching my video. प्लीज कमेंट, लाइक, शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब, एंड प्लीज कमेंट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स वेदर यू आर सब्सक्राइबिंग टू इट टू द IPO. थैंक यू.